Hi everyone, my name is Rachel and I'm from the Cliniko support team. In this Cliniko course, I'll walk you through some of our recommended steps to get your account up and running quickly. When it comes to creating or setting up a new Cliniko account, keep in mind you have the ability to customize your account to your business and your needs. We added some default services, communication templates, and settings in the account to get you started, but feel free to edit or use these as needed. Best part, you can also set up Cliniko on a computer, tablet, or even mobile device. If you have any questions, though, reach out to our team by selecting Help within your Cliniko account menu. You can also send us a message at any time, and we'll be there to assist. From the Help menu, you also have quick access to additional videos, tutorials, and tips for using Cliniko. Let's get started with setting up the admin and account information. To do this, you'll want to make sure you're logged in as an administrator within your Cliniko account, and then head to Settings. Under the section Our Clinic, select General Settings. When you first signed up for Cliniko, we automatically added some contact details into the account information area. However, double-check that this information is correct. The name and email listed here is our primary contact for any administrative notifications or billing-related matters. Under Location, make sure the country, time zone, and currency is also correct. When sending out communications or notifications to patients or practitioners, we will use the time zone listed here to determine what time to send out those communications. Just note, you can set up separate time zones for your users in their profile settings. From here, you have a number of customization options and settings, including whether the terminology patient or client is used throughout Cliniko and online booking. You can also select certain permission settings for your practitioners, receptionists, and power receptionists. Set up your appointment calendar preferences, which controls how the appointment page looks internally and for your entire team, as well as change waitlist and security settings. All of these options can be updated or enabled in the future, but before saving your changes, we recommend checking the communications section. Here, you can set up the default email address that will receive patient replies. For example, patient replies to confirmation emails, reminders, invoices, or letters. Finally, you can select the default reminder type, which will determine whether new patients added to the system will be automatically set to receive reminders via email, SMS, both, or none. Once finished, make sure to save your settings. Now, let's move forward with editing and updating your business information.